there are a couple of different ways to approach it, I guess. One of the things they could do would be to just, I mean, extend the on-street parking for 72 hours or maybe longer. The other thing is maybe a solution would be to issue permits for people that don't have garages or driveways so that they can park their cars on the street for extended periods of time. If your vehicle needs to be moved while you're away, you can always leave keys with a neighbor or a friend to get the vehicles moved, but that might be one solution. But there has to be a better solution than us starting our vehicles or having a neighbor start our vehicles and every 36 hours and drive them around the block. That to me isn't a real solution to anything.
How did you feel when you came back and found out your car had been
towed? Well, we were mad, and I mean, first thing we did was we phoned the police department, phoned the police service, and told them our car was stolen, and of course they checked right away, and no, it wasn't stolen. So we were angry, I guess, you know, to put it mildly. But
well, we've lived here for 40 years, and we don't have a garage or a driveway, and we've always parked on the street, and it's never been an issue. And the city encourages us to take public transit, ride our bikes, walk, which we do all the time, and our neighbors do as well. But don't leave your vehicle parked for 36 hours, or it could be ticketed or towed away. And I believe that they should be able to somehow make allowances for people like us that don't have a garage or driveway and don't have a choice but park on the street. And we have residential parking permits on our vehicles because we don't have a garage or a driveway. And I think they should recognize that vehicles that have that should be some allowance for us to park longer than 36 hours on the street.